So let's see how we will find the percentage of a number without using a calculator. As you can see, there is a table here that you need to memorize that gives you a basic idea of how some percentages can be found simply by dividing. For example, 1% can be found simply by dividing by 100. 5% is the fraction 1 over 20 actually, which means that we can find 5% just dividing by 20, and so on. So we will use this table here to answer these questions. 1% of 250. 1% means we need to divide by 100. So 250 divide by 100, that's 2.5. So 1% of 250 is actually 2.5. 5% of 60. 5% means that we just need to divide by 20, so 60 divide by 20, that's 3, so 5% of 60 is actually 3. 20% of 420, 20% means that we need to divide by 5, so this is just 420 divide by 5. If you can't do it mentally, just use a bus stop. Eight fives in 42, with a remainder of 2. How many fives are in 20? 4. So 420 divided by 5 is actually 84. 50% of 45, 50% is actually a half, so that should be 22.5. And for the 25% of 560, 25% means divide by 4. Once again, a bus stop can be helpful. 1, and then carry 1. 4, and then carry 0, 0. So that is 140. And that's how we can also find 10% and so on. Now, using this method, we can actually find pretty much every percentage. Only we will need to be doing more steps. If that's the case, you can work as in the next examples that I will show you. The first one that we need to find 3%, and the second one that we need to find 27%. So for 3%, I'm actually going to find 1% first. 1% of 210 is 210 divided by 100, which is 2.1. Now, since I'm looking for 3%, if 1% is 2.1, I just need to times by 3. So 3% of 210 is in fact 6.3. If I have 27% of 80, a way to do it, for example, would be split 27% into 25% and 2%. Find each one of them on its own and then add these two together. So for the 25%, this is divided by 4. 80 divided by 4, that's 20. For the 2%, I will start by the 1%. Divided by 100, that's 0.8. I need 2%, so I will just double that. Now, 25% is 20, 2% is 1.6, so for the 27%, I just need to add these two. So 27% of 80 is 21.6. As you can see, even if I need to do more steps, I can calculate pretty much every percentage using this method.